couple of years, Jed Booth and some of the other ranchers raid the bands of wild horses and ship them off to the market. There's Booth, over there.
Did you ever ride the horses, Uncle Hank?
Oh, Tommy. Me and my men never go on the drives. We sort of feel as if the horses belonged here. They lived here. This is their home. Here they raise their families.
The horses have families too?
Why, yes, of course, Tommy, just the same as we do. And that's why I sort of feel as if it wasn't fair to drive them off like they are doing down there now.
See, they got that big black horse again.
Diablo? Yes. They got him last year and the year before that. But he's a pretty clever horse. Pretty smart.
Diablo standing in the stream, Pete?
Yep. That's him, all right. Grandpa can tell you all about him.
Tell me about Diablo.
Oh, that's all right, Whitey, that's all right. You and I know about Diablo, don't we?
Whitey know Diablo?
Well, yes, of course he does. I tell you about him.
Yeah, don't forget to tell him about the little mule, too.
You better tell him about the mule, Pete. The mule was a friend of yours.
What do you mean?
You figure that out.
I want to hear about Diablo.
Well, you see, Tommy, Whitey used to be a wild horse, just like Diablo and the rest of them down there. Come in with his men, and he kept Whitey and Diablo along with the others.
Yep, that's when they caught him.
Yeah, that's right, they caught him. But Whitey and Diablo, they escaped.
Yeah. The little mule followed Whitey in a few meters.
Whitey and Diablo go away together?
The black fella? No, sir. No, he plays a lone hand. Pretty soon he come across a pinto, and he's hurt. And immediately they begun to fight.
Good fight.
But he was no max for the black horse.
Diablo licked that Pedro and took possession of his hood. I reckon he thought that he could whip anything.
Back to the gal I'm anxious to see.
What happened to White?
Oh, that's a long story. Ain't it, old fella?
Yep, and more exciting than what happens to most humans.
Gosh, Uncle Hank.
Yeah?
You've got to tell me.
I'll tell you what I'll do, Tony. Come on, get down. Now, tomorrow we'll get up early, and while we're going over to watch the drive, I'll tell you the story of White.
And when his days on this world are over, to a horse's heaven is such a place be. I know that he'll like the change, if it looks just like the range. Round my home, back in Cactus Valley,
I got a home
back in Cactus Valley.
Such a pretty home
like you never did see. Where the desert flowers grow, that is where Valley.
And when my days
on the plains are over,
for when I am called
by the boss man above, I have only got one prayer, that it's just as pretty there as my.
Fine, boys, fine. I didn't know you could sing that well.
Thanks, boss. How about a song from you, Tommy?
Oh, I can't sing.
Oh, yes, you can. I heard Slim teaching you a song the other day.
Oh, well, we was only fooling.
Oh, go ahead, Tommy. Sing him the song.
I wanna be a great big buckaroo, just like the other cowboys that I know. I wanna be a great big buckaroo and ride at every rodeo. I wanna mount my horse and ride the plains and down upon the flat. I want to use one hand to hold the reins, and with the other swing my lariat. I'm craving for a cowboy's life so merry. When payday comes around to town we'd go. Oh, I could handle any herd of steer and stop a stampede too. I wanna be a great big buckaroo like you.
Morning, son.
Where's Uncle Hank?
Well, he's over by the last barn.
Thanks, Johnny.
Shall I saddle Tommy's horse for him?
Oh, you might as well. We'll be leaving soon.
All right. Since you taught him how to cinch his own saddle, he don't want anybody fooling with his horse. He wants to do everything for himself.
You know, he's like a little maverick. No father. No mother. You know, Peter, don't seem right for a little fellow like that to be without at least one parent, does it?
Pretty tough. But then I guess he's lucky to have an uncle like you to look after him.
Oh, he goes along without complaining. But sometimes the little fella seems to wonder about things.
Yep, he sure can ask a heap of questions, can't he?
Oh, you said it. But he's like all little boys.
I reckon it is kind of hard living out here with us old fellas, with no kids to play with. I guess city folks see more and learn quicker.
I don't know about that. Seems to me nature laid down the same set of rules for all of us. Kind of universal. Makes no difference where we live.
Maybe you're right, Hank. Here he comes now.
Morning, Tommy.
Morning, Uncle Hank. Morning, Pete.
Morning.
You see, I got up early. I'm all ready to hear that story.
Fine. Well, come on. Let's get cinched up and get started. Got a lot to do. All right, go on. Did you think that I'd forgotten you? No, old sideboard. I wouldn't forget you. No, I know what day this is. You're going to have a run. This is your holiday, Whitey. And we're going right up to the gate. You see, Tommy, how well he knows where the gate is? You know where the gate is, don't you, Whitey? I'll say you do. Now, stay back, Tom. Go on here, Whitey. There you go for your run. Bad up, boy. Look at it.
Won't he run away?
No, he hasn't run away yet.
Why do you turn him out every day like this?
Oh, just part of a bargain I made with him.
How can you make a bargain with a horse?
Tommy, after I've told you the story of Whitey, you'll understand how it is that I figure that sometimes horses are like people with the same kind of problems. There you are.
Why aren't you riding Whitey today?
Oh, I rode Whitey today pretty hard. So today's his holiday to do as he pleases, huh? Deal stick nearby. Come on, let's get started. You know, there's going to be plenty to do it over there at the drive. While Diablo was stealing the Pinto's mares, becoming leader of the herd, sort of setting himself up as king, Whitey went back to pick up what Boo had left him of his herd and set out to find a new home on water.
They roamed west towards the foothills of the big mountains, where they found water.
And the mule, he went along too.
That's right, Tommy. Now, Whitey figured that maybe they could live here in peace and contentment, sort of enjoy the freedom of their newfound home. Whitey watched over his herd, but one day their enemy, man, discovered them. It was Booth who had tracked Whitey from the roundup where he'd made his escape. Whitey had to act quickly. He found a way to outwit Booth. He let Booth see him and then led him away on a long, hard chase so that the herd and the mares could make their escape. Safely away from Booth and his. Whitey led them further north to an enchanting spot where there's a big lake. This was far from the beaten paths of man.
Hello.
There, in the peaceful beauty of the new home, Whitey began to think of romance.
You're going to like this, Tommy.
Oh, shucks. Boys don't like that love stuff much. I know. But it brought about a change in Whitey's life. Kinda like the first step towards his ultimate destiny.
Anyway, Whitey's pal, the mule, got a big kick out of it. To know that love is the same in any life.
Well, that's right, Pete. But it helps. You ought to know.
Oh, go ahead with your story.
Well, Tommy, there isn't much you can say about love. Whitey picked a fine-looking pinto mare for his mate. Then, one day, there was a new member added to Whitey's family. A finer colt as ever was born to a mare. Whitey was proud of his young son. He taught him all the lore of the reins, raised him so that one day he would be strong and brave and smart enough to take care of himself. Yes, and maybe become leader of a herd like his daddy. He would be there to protect his young. Whitey was looking after him and protecting him. And he would kind of thank his daddy in the way little colts have of showing their affection. For a spell, the herd lived in quiet and contentment. The colt continued to grow into a fine young man, but there were many things Whitey still had to teach him, like the day the little fella got frightened of some cottontail rabbits. Of course, they wouldn't harm a soul, but Whitey had to show this to his son. Wandered away from the herd and got lost. He was frightened as he strayed about alone in the dark. He went out to search for him and brought him back safely to his mother. This happiness Whitey and his herd had found was destined to be rudely shattered.
Wolves soon Whitey's tracks and located his new home and near the lake.
But he didn't catch him, did he?
Ah, don't get ahead of our story, boy. Wolves did dig a pit track, hoping that Whitey would get into it, and then he'd be captured.
Well, what was funny about that?
You'll find out, son.
You gonna tell me, Uncle Hank?
Yep. He did build a track for him. But Whitey was too smart. You see, Whitey had an awful lot of trouble with Booth, and he was always on the alert, ready to protect his herd.
Whitey came one day with his herd into the vicinity of Booth's traps.
Hugh was tagging along as usual, wasn't he, Hank?
Yes, wherever the herd went, anyone that day. Whitey rescued the mule from Booth. Bird had moved away to safety. Whitey appeared. Diablo, the black horse. Pablo proceeded to kidnap Whitey's mate. Whitey searched successfully for his mate. She had gone back to the herd after escaping from the lord, but the colt was still lost in the wilderness.
pretty scared. You can't blame him. It's no fun to have a pack of hungry wolves chasing you.
Hi. Whitey had a lot of trouble with Wolf and Diablo and the wolves.
His troubles was only beginning. You wait till you grow up and you'll find out. Troubles always comes in bunches.
Gosh, it's almost like Whitey was a human being with a family, you know.
Yes, Tommy. I guess they have their difficulties and their family squabbles just like us folks.
Just wait till you grow up and get married and have your family problems, too.
I don't think I'll ever get...
Oh, wait till you see how sweet it is to make up.
Look, Uncle Hank. Pete's crying.
What? Oh, So will you be if you was eating the kind of apple he's eating.
Oh, I like onions. Apples don't agree with me nohow. Tell him what happened next, how the family got together again.
Well, after Whitey had driven off the wolves, he and the little colt went on through the night and arrived at their camp. But Whitey wasn't pleased about his mare having run off with Diablo. Attaboy. And so the little colt, seeing that there was discord in the family, he decided...
And you know the old saying, a little child shall lead them? Well, here it is.
Yeah. All right, boys. Time that the little colt had brought about peace in the family, Diablo came back. This time, Whitey decided to have it out with the black horse, once and for all. Thank you.
prepared for the battle which was to prove who was king of the range.
I got an idea. No sense of trying to rope him down in there. You fire that rim and I'll take care of this. Smoke them to the gap and we'll catch them as they come out.
Okay.
rides later. He wandered into the South Corral at the ranch. And you know Jim the foreman? Well, he doctored up his poor little burnt legs.
Whitey and the Colt's mother were watching him. So he figured he'd get out of the way and see what they'd do. Like any mother would. It took him a little while to make up his mind just what he wanted to do about it. Country. But when he found out that we wanted to be friendly and we didn't mean any harm to his family, he decided to stay. That's how I come to make the bargain with him. I promised him that I'd let him run loose every day out all over the wild country if he promised not to run away. Because he's still a wild horse at heart, so Tommy, you see how it pays to keep your word with people.
Then what happened to Diablo?
Oh, Diablo's still a wild horse. And in this year's drive, they caught him again.
Look, that's Diablo now.
Thank you.
how they could expect to hold that horse. Diablo's loose again. Somewhere out on the range, out in the wild horse country, there's another drama starting. I don't think Whitey would be scared, because he's learned there's more contentment in an ordered, civilized life than in running wild. You know, a lot of people could take lessons from Whitey, because after all, he's a wild horse at heart, but he's satisfied. Ain't you, Whitey? Satisfied to be guided by good and gentle influence.